Hey guys, I'm Tom the Tech Chap, and I've been using this as my main work slash office slash studio monitor for the past month. It's 49 inches, has a 5K resolution, an IPS panel, and a super ultra-wide 32:9 aspect ratio. So it's like having two normal 16:9 Quad HD monitors side by side, but obviously without a huge bezel in the middle and only half the number of cables. So the LG 49W-L95C also supports HDR10. It has a USB-C port in addition to HDMI and DisplayPort, stereo 10-watt speakers, picture-in-picture modes, and an ambient light sensor. All in, you're looking at about $1,500, which is a lot of money, but I mean, you are getting a lot of monitor. So when LG reached out and offered to send this thing out, it was actually really good timing because I'd just come from testing another super ultra-wide monitor, a Philips, which you can check out my review of, it's on my channel, and I loved, but the problem is, I broke it. It fell off the stand, which was a bit faulty, so then I was without super ultra-wide. But now, LG came to the rescue, and this is taking up, well, my entire desk, basically. Fast forward a little over a month, and I've been using this as my main work monitor, and so I wanted to share with you guys my experience of using it so far. So when I first set this thing up, my first thought was, wow, this thing is stunning in both sheer size and also the design. But my second thought was, it seems a bit narrow, perhaps? And I think that's because it has such narrow bezels, especially on the top and the sides. And so with that super wide 32:9 aspect ratio, it did look a little bit narrow. And I would love an option to have, say, a 32:10 screen, so there's a little bit more space at the top and bottom. That would just be my preference, but I do also realize that with this size and resolution and the panel, that we are really at the cutting edge of technology. There is a solution though, if you have very deep pockets and one 49-inch monitor isn't enough. You could just get a second one. LG have moved the OSD joystick to the right-hand side rather than underneath, so you can actually now stack two of these together on top of each other. That seems pretty crazy to me, but if you're a stock trader, a coder, or graphic designer, or just someone who needs even more screen real estate, it is cool that you have the option. For me, one of the standout features of this monitor is the design. It's one of the best looking displays I've ever used. It is heavy, but it feels solid and well made with that brushed metal stand. If you have used one of LG's more recent monitors, then you'll be familiar with this arc metal stand. And one thing I do love about it is that I can push it right to the back of my desk and it doesn't actually protrude that much. My desk isn't that wide, it's about 60 centimeters. I can actually push it right back and I still have a little over half of my desk, and you get quite a lot of flexibility. You can swivel, tilt and adjust the height, or even visa wall mount it. So it's a lot more flexible than most other monitors like this. I was also pleasantly surprised to see there's no bulky power brick. They must have found room to include it internally, so there's just a simple 3-pin power cable that goes straight to the wall outlet. You also get an ambient light sensor up top, which you can enable in the settings, so it automatically adjusts the brightness based on the lighting around you. It's a cool idea, but if I'm honest, it didn't work that well for me, often dimming the display even in my bright studio. I can't fault the speakers though. You get stereo 10-watt speakers with what LG call rich bass, and they are among the best I've ever heard from built-in speakers. Although obviously you can't beat a good pair of headphones or a proper external speaker setup. So I'm using this monitor for pretty much everything. Work, watching videos, gaming, although LG aren't really aiming at gamers. I mean, there's nothing stopping you from loading up a bit of Battlefield 5 or Apex Legends and being completely immersed in the game. Along with that gentle curve of the screen, playing games with this aspect ratio and high resolution looks incredible. Although the downsides are it's limited to 60Hz, there's no FreeSync or G-Sync, and if you do want to push that 5120x1440 res with high settings, well, you'll need a pretty beefy PC. But whatever you're using it for, that screen size, that aspect, you just have so much space. Having a Premiere Pro timeline fill up the entire screen is incredible, and I can have a bigger space for all my project files and video clips. I genuinely feel like this speeds up my editing. Although if I do have a lot going on, I'll jump into LG's on-screen control app and maybe split it into four areas for, say, Google Docs, email, YouTube, and a folder tab. And I mean, with a monitor this size, it's not totally crazy to have an 8-way split. Now the monitor doesn't have a physical KVM switch, but with LG's dual controller software, you can basically do the same thing. Download the program on each device, it'll work with up to four, and then select one as the main PC and then one as the sub PC. And make sure they're both connected to the same network so they can see each other. It's all done wirelessly. Then in the OSD, select picture by picture and choose the layout you want. That's it. You can then share the same mouse and keyboard on both devices and even transfer files by dragging them to the little green box at the edge of the screen. It works really well. And of course, it also supports regular picture-in-picture mode. So you can hook up, say, your laptop and then go to the OSD and then select which layout and size you want. And it worked over both HDMI and USB-C. Now, the LG's USB-C isn't Thunderbolt 3, which is a bit disappointing, but you can still output from your laptop and use the monitor as an external display at its full 5K res at 60Hz, so that is all you need. Plus, the USB-C also carries 85 watts of power, so it'll charge your laptop while you've got it hooked up. It's not all about the size though, the quality of the display is really important as well. And at this size and resolution, we're looking at 108 ppi. So it's the same sharpness as you get on a standard 27-inch Quad HD monitor. The IPS panel has great viewing angles, which given the size of this thing is pretty important, and it covers 100% of the sRGB and 79% of the Adobe RGB color gamuts. Brightness peaks at 350 nits, which is good, although it's not really bright enough to give you a great HDR experience. I do love this thing, it's close to being my perfect monitor. As a full-time video producer and occasionally when I have a spare minute, a bit of a gamer, I can't fault the design, the display quality, the speakers, the sort of the ports and connections, although Thunderbolt 3 would have been nice. So I don't think this is gonna get replaced anytime soon. I'm definitely switching to this. What do you think though? Would you consider buying a super ultra wide like this? Let me know in the comments below. And if you do fancy buying this particular model, you can find links in the description. Thank you so much for watching, guys. A big thanks to LG for sending out the monitor. Hit that like and subscribe button if you enjoyed the video and like to see more of my stuff. And I'll see you next time right here on the Tech Chap.